And we're so thrilled to have, you know, new members here, prospective members, and those that just want to refresh on their membership. So as you can see here, our vision is to make Colorado the number one state for advancing women in business. It's a lofty goal. We like to say we're boiling the ocean, but we'll start with Colorado first and go from there. Judging by the heat today, I think we are boiling Colorado, but it's fine. next slide, Yahtzee. As we mentioned, you all put your name and organizations on the box, so thank you for that. And a little bit about our history and purpose here at the Colorado Women's Chamber of Commerce, or what we call CWCC. We were founded in the late 80s. Right now, we have about 435 member companies that are about 1,800 active members. So some of our larger companies have multiple individuals, and then some are solopreneurs. So those are kind of how we get our numbers there. Our mission is to provide women with opportunities that better our economy, community, and promote equity in the workplace. We also too want to help women grow their businesses and their careers. And we do that in a couple different ways, but community, connection, and development are kind of our three North Stars, as we'd like to call them. And as mentioned, we want to make Colorado the best state for everybody. So excited for that. We are a pretty small but mighty team. So we have four full-time staff folks. So you have two of us, half the team here today. Our CEO, Simone Ross, joined the organization about a year and a half ago. I'm the program manager, been with the organization a little over 2 years. Yahtzee is about a year and a half, and Kate, our newest member, she joined the team about a year ago. So we are still fairly new, but we're taking on some really great changes to the organization that we'll talk about here shortly. So part of everyone's membership level includes our programs and events. Dependent on your membership level, you can have free access to these programs. And in some cases, you also too, there's discounted rates for some of our events that are in person or our larger ticket items that we'll talk about momentarily. But our peer groups are open to the community, or to our CWCC community for free of charge, unless it's a big event that we're hosting, a lunch or something like that. And then again, that small nominal fee to help just cover baseline costs. But our four peer groups really are meeting monthly. We took July off to recalibrate for the summer, and then we'll gear back up here in a couple weeks with our first peer group in August. But we have two groups that are really focused on those founders and business owners, and that's our Founders Forum and our CEO Forum. So if you are starting a business, interested in starting a business, or even to just want to support those that are in the business community, our small business community, the Founders Forum is for you. We rotate between resource sharing, networking, and masterminding to really help support our founders within our community. Our CEO Forum is really geared towards those businesses that make about $1 million in revenue or more. It changes a little bit since the pandemic, but $1 million is usually where we want to start and then continuing on. So it's those founders that are having some like-minded challenges with those in the community to share their experiences. We have our Women's Advancement Group. And this is for kind of anybody broadly. And it's really issues that are impacting women in advancing in their businesses, in their careers, or kind of just making career shifts. So what does that look like? A great example is we had a LinkedIn workshop. So how to refresh your LinkedIn for your business or for your personal LinkedIn. Similarly, we've done some board service pieces as well. So those are kind of topics that we do cover within that group. And our last group, we're actually rebranding as of August. So we're really excited about that. Instead of business development, it's going to be business breakthroughs. So it's really just resource sharing on a different topic every month. And so a great example is employee resource groups, or ERGs is a panel that we want to bring into that, you know, sharing just what are some tools, tips, and tricks that can help support your businesses or you as a professional. We then also too have additional programming that we do on top of our peer groups that meet monthly. And I should say those peer groups usually about an hour or so, and they rotate between in-person and virtual. We hope in 2024 that we bring those all back in person, but right now, just from an accessibility standpoint, some virtual programming there has been helpful. Our programs here though, is our Women of Impact and Influence Leadership Lab, which we also to this summer, which we're excited about, is we're rebranding to our Leadership Lab. And that is a cohort-based program that does meet 10 months. A full Friday a month, and the cohort really focuses on their own leadership growth, but also to creating and finishing a capstone program or project. And this year, our group then presented their findings on their project to a group of about 150 or so community members. And those topics really focused on allyship, equity, retention and advancement in the workplace, and then also cultural norms. So really trying to address and create solutions for those issues that are impacting women in work. Our mentorship program is really geared towards, so our Leadership Lab is geared towards those emerging leaders, as our mentorship program is really geared towards those that are looking to move into the C-suite or executive level in the next year or two. And this is a small group mentoring that we do. There's a panel and then one-on-one mentoring, but it does meet for a few hours once a month for 6 months. Those are both application-based programs, and there is additional fee to participate in those. But our applications are going live this week, which we're excited about. And so Yahtzee will send those in the follow-up email post this event. And you can definitely check out on our website to those applications. Those will run through end of August. Our Powerful Voices Conversation Series is one of my favorite. We actually just brought it back full-time in person last month. And we will be hosting another one of those in September. And it's where we really call behind the bio of some of our amazing speakers or community leaders. Our session in June was really focused on women in food and beverage and different avenues of that, both business owners behind the scenes and then front of house. So it was a great panel to talk about challenges of women in work when it comes to that industry. So it's really behind the bio, getting really in depth with some of those and getting some experiences. Like, I just found out I'm not weird. I'm just Italian because I eat my pizza with a fork. And apparently that's what we do in Italy. So thank goodness I attended that session and learned that. And then our Young Professionals Board, it's a board that we have that is an application-based board. Those will open up this fall, but they also do additional programming. And so Yahtzee will talk about one of their upcoming events in August, but that programming is open to the broader community, regardless of age. They just kind of gear some of their topics towards those that are emerging or young professionals, but definitely is a great opportunity for anyone to engage with our community there. We also have, as part of your membership, committees that you can join. Depending on your committee or depending on your membership level, you can participate in some of these committees. Right now, the only one that is broadly open to our CWCC community is our policy committee. They are taking kind of a lighter summer, but we'll be ramping back up in August and September to really gear towards kind of the policies and policy pillars and areas of focus that we as a chamber want to participate in the next legislative session. They do meet monthly virtually and also do host additional programming that's open to the CWCC public. We also have, and I oversee that committee, our DEI committee is Yahtzee. She oversees that. And we're looking to hopefully open up that committee more broadly to CWCC community in the next 6 months or early in 2024. So our hope is that we can get some more members engaged in our DEI programming, our DEI committee, and then how that can influence some of our programming. And then lastly is our membership and growth committee. That's a new one that we are starting this year, later this year, or early next, opening that up too. And that's with our membership manager or partnership manager, Kate. And kind of lastly, as much as I love our programs, I'm obsessed with our events, and it's not just because I like to get dressed up. We have three key events that are listed here, and then I'll mention a fourth. But our events here are really focused on kind of bringing awareness, but also to celebrating amazing women in our community. So State of Women in Business is an event that we will hold in February. Last year, our keynote speaker actually was with the Department of Labor Women's Bureau, and they came to speak about national trends that are happening with women in work. We also then too had a panel that was led by our great partners at Amazon. And then we also were fortunate enough to have pretty much the State of the Union address again from Governor Polis. So that was a great event. So that will be again a breakfast event happening in February next year. We also too, our Champions of Change has actually moved into our Leadership Lab Summit. So that's the culminating event, as I mentioned, that's open to the public, where our cohort will actually give and give presentations that are about the key issues that are changing and hopefully support and recognize those companies that are doing some great work. One that's not mentioned here, but we're really excited to officially add back to this list is our Athena Leadership Award. It's a lifetime achievement award that is in December. And that is something that nominations for that award will be opening this fall. But it's just recognizing an amazing leader in the community. Last year's recipient was Lauren Castile, and she's done some great work, obviously, with the Women's Foundation, but also too just generally supporting women in work and advancing them. And our most, you know, favorite one, biggest one, whatever we want to call it, our 11th year is this happening in a couple weeks, which is Top 25 Most Powerful Women in Business. Tickets are in sale for that, and Yancy will give a little bit more background there, and I can drop some links into you all as she talks about that. But it is where we recognize and honor 25 women and one legacy winner for their amazing work that they've done in the community. So you don't want to miss it. Don't worry, I already have my dress picked out. It's a big thing. So hopefully the whole office will color coordinate with what I'm wearing.
We'll see about that. thank you, Leah. Moving forward with a couple more benefits that I want to bring to your attention. If you didn't already know, we just launched our new job board and resume bank. If you haven't checked it out, please do so at cwcc.mcjobboard.net/jobs. You can also find this website in our resource drop-down list on our website, which is cwcc.org. This is powered by Denver Public Schools. And again, we're super grateful for them to have given us the opportunity to launch this super great tool, because not only are members able to post their opportunities or company opportunities to the job board, but you now have access to, as a job seeker, to upload your resume if you are interested in having that viewed. And also any talent recruitment, you know, members of your company, depending on your membership level, have access to that as well. So if you have any questions on what your membership looks like with this benefit, please let me know. Please contact me. But if whether you are looking to promote an opportunity or you're looking to apply for an opportunity, we're really excited to roll this out. So again, in that follow-up email, I will make sure to provide this link as well as our guide that can walk you through the process of how to post a job board and how to upload a resume. All right, member clicks. I'm sure everyone has heard about it, about our great data migration that happened last fall. It's exciting to know that we are almost a year in since we've launched. If you haven't set up your login, please make sure to contact me, because we have a lot of great engagement tools coming your way later this year that you will need that login for. A great example is the job board. You do need that login to make sure you have that access to post the job. I didn't mention in the last slide, but just to make sure I put that out there, job seekers, you don't have to be members to upload a resume. The public can as well. So if you know of a friend who's looking for a job, please make sure you direct them that way. They are more than welcome to upload the resume so it can be viewed by our membership recruitment. In terms of workshops for making sure that you are all set to go before we launch some other great engagement tools, they will be coming in the first week of August. Again, we will be sending these dates out to you in the upcoming weeks. Make sure you sign up for them. And again, these sessions will include a 15-minute overview. This can be a refresher. We hosted these a couple months ago. So just in case you're unfamiliar with it, again, it's a 15-minute overview of the main functions, which includes adding representatives, switching between accounts, making sure changes and company updates are made through the company profile. And again, a little bit of an overview of the interest and communications preferences, because that is going to be tied to our community online platform that will launch in a couple months. So again, those dates will be coming soon. But I think right now, if you're unable to make those workshops and you do not have a login, please make sure to reach out to me. As mentioned, we do have some great launches coming soon. Be on the lookout for our community calendar. This will allow you to be able to share any events that your company is hosting. And again, this is just a great benefit to make sure that our community is feeling connected and they're putting their opportunities out there for engagement as well on their end. And then the online community platform, a little background on that, it's going to be essentially a hub for all of our active members to connect. It will include discussion boards and forums, as well as it's a great way for you to join a committee. And if you can't make our in-person meetings in the future, this is going to be where everything lives. So again, we're looking for ways to make sure we are creating accessibility for everyone, because we understand that everyone can make in-person meetings or keep up in person. So again, be on the lookout for that. If you have any questions about your benefits or any questions about these launches, feel free to send me an email at ygarcia@cwcc.org. And then last but not least, we want to make sure we put some upcoming events on your radar. I'm sure you all saw that we launched our Beat the Burnout campaign. So we were taking a break this month. But again, although we are doing some self-care, we are also working on bringing these great upcoming events to you as well this month. So make sure you check them out and you register by going to our website. And again, that login is super important, because that's the way you will be getting the CWCC rate. So the first one I want to put on your radar is our leadership and mentorship information session. This session is going to be covering everything from any questions you might have about the program, what it consists of, the materials we're planning for you, to essentially those of you who are main contacts, how to select a candidate, who is the right fit for this program or for either program. So if you're interested in learning more about the requirements, learning more about the programs, please register for this, because this is going to be your opportunity to hop in and ask these questions in one place. Again, applications, I know Leah mentioned this, we will be rolling those out in the upcoming weeks. So please keep an eye out. And also, I will be including those links to the applications in the follow-up email, so you get that first access to the applications, as opposed to waiting until our social media post goes out. So keep an eye out for that. The other event we want to put on your radar is our Young Professionals Board's open house. It will be on August 29th from 4 to 6 p.m. Location is still to be determined, but it will be in person. It is $10 for members and $15 for non-members. Again, this is a great way for any of your young professional or young talent to get more involved in the chamber by getting to meet the current board, getting to meet the staff, and asking any questions they might have about the requirements and the criteria and the expectations of being on the board, and ultimately the application process. And then last but not least, as Leah mentioned, our Top 25 Most Powerful Women in Business event is in August. Again, it's crazy to think it's almost in a month. If you haven't bought your tickets, please do so. Nominations are closed. And saying that, if you start thinking about other women to select, we will be rolling out those applications in the beginning of next. Sorry, Leah, let me not put that deadline out there. It is actually going to be closer to the summer of 2024. But again, if you are unfamiliar on how this event goes, I highly encourage you to join us. If you are unable to join us for the gala, we will be also hosting an after party. So if you are unable to make it to the award ceremony, the after party is a great way to still get to meet and hang and network with the top 25 most powerful women in business, as well as the Legacy Award winner. So again, this will be August 17th in person. Tickets are on sale, as well as sponsorships. If you have any questions, please feel free to let us know. We will also be including more information on that in the follow-up email. And here are some member tools and resources. Again, this is all available on our website, but we will make sure to include this presentation so you're able to have the access to it if you want to click on any of these shortcuts. And then obviously stay in touch. I'm sure most of you have our emails. We're pretty easy to get a hold of, which is great. So in case you don't have our emails, I have them listed here. Again, we will provide this copy of the PowerPoint and that follow-up email so you are able to have that quick access. And then last but not least, please follow us on social media. This is a great way to stay plugged in. If you haven't signed up for our newsletter, please do so by visiting our website. If you need help doing that, please contact me and I am more than happy to get you added. And that concludes our presentation.